As National reassembles itself after being dismantled by its second worst election performance ever, it has a new deputy leader. Dr. Shane Reti, arguably the party's best performer during the past few dismal months, was elected unopposed yesterday. He's beginning his third term as MP. But he's enjoyed a meteoric rise in public consciousness in recent months, in part prompted by his measured critiques and at times even praise of the government's COVID-19 response. This has been in reasonably sharp contrast to the oppositional tone of much of National's campaigning in general. Dr. Reti, Deputy Leader, joins us from our Wellington studio. Mōrena, tēnā koe. Congratulations.
Kia ora koutou e hōma. Good morning, John. Nice to speak with you and thank you.
Yeah, nice to speak to you. That's a lovely smile. What's it like to be Deputy Leader of the National Party?
An absolute privilege to have the trust and support of your colleagues and the direction of the party. So I stand here today privileged to hold this position.
Yeah. Yours is an extraordinary story, and you talked about it in your maiden speech, which is a really good read. What, your mum left school after the fifth form, your dad left school after the fourth form. You became an acclaimed and beloved local MP in Whangarei. You went and taught at Harvard, for goodness sake. It's a remarkable story, isn't it?
Look, I think it's a story, as I say in my maiden speech, where my parents understood the value of education, what education could do. They hadn't participated themselves necessarily in higher education, but they just thought there was something important there, enough for them to work two jobs so that we could have the opportunities to participate.
Why are you in that?
Why am I?
Yeah, why the National Party?
When I door knock, I get asked two questions, and that's one of them. The first is, Shane, we need more docs than we need MPs, and you're a good doc, go back and be a doc. And the second one is, why are you red? With all the social good you do, you should be red. How can that be? The left don't own social good. And so I'm a Nat because for a long time I've believed in the principles that are inherent with the National Party, the principles of equality of opportunity. That's why I'm a Nat, because I believe in the principles.
Boy, they were principles the electorate didn't buy, did they? And it's the second worst performance ever. What went wrong, do you think?
Look, I think there's the external factors that we had less control over, and then the internal factors that we're doing a review of, and they've been well canvassed in the media.
Have they? Boy, every time I ask somebody in the National Party about what went wrong, they say the Prime Minister had the stage for COVID. It doesn't look like you're canvassing the internal factors at all.
Oh, yes, no, our review is doing exactly that. In fact, our MPs, and I'll be doing exactly the same on Thursday, are going back out to the membership in an open forum and saying, what did we do wrong? How can we do better? How can we better serve you? And by the way, it's not just to the membership, it's non-members as well, because we want to serve all of New Zealand. So we're going out as a clean slate to be rewritten and say, how can we do a better job? How can we be more relevant to you?
Do you already know the answer to that question? I mean, I'm really struck by how different your tone was during the past few months from almost all of your colleagues. I mean, all of your colleagues, not all of them, but most of them seem to me to be stridently oppositional. And David Longy said in 1984, and it's a very important thing for opposition parties to remember, if you look like an opposition, you remain one. Whereas you always seem to be constructive to the point that from time to time, you actually said Chris Hipkins and the government were getting it right.
Because they were, and I'll give attribution as long as the day is long to good works. You know, our job here, and it's that fine balance, is to critique, but then also to come with solutions and collaborate, and that's the sort of composure I like to have.
So aren't you answering the previous question? Isn't that what National has to do?
Yes, it may well be more that we need to bring more of our deep thinking towards the answers rather than just point out the holes, come forward with the depth of talent we've got and prosecute more of the solutions and then let the government talk it down. If it's a good idea, it's a good idea in anyone's hands.
You tell an amazing story about wanting to up your workload to achieve more faster at school and being told you couldn't because you're Māori, right? Which is remarkable. How do we overcome that kind of systemic, ingrained racism?
So we need to put that in the context of the time that it was. That was back in the late 70s. And I think we're a more informed and knowledgeable society around systemic racism, around organisational racism. And I think we need to continue to prosecute that, understand, recognise that it is there, and then come up with culturally relevant interventions so that we all up our games, that we all understand it and actually do something about it. I think that's what we need to do. Having said that, for me, it was also a, right, I'll show you. If that's the hurdle you're going to put in front of me, watch out, here I come.
Can I ask you, and this may be a segue, or it may be just a radical departure to another subject, and we'll leave viewers to draw their own conclusions, but why did it take National so long to appreciate what they had in you? I mean, why, boy, you are a GP, what, 7 years on the Northland DHB, you studied at Harvard, you're an actual doctor. Why did it take until July this year for you to become National's health spokesperson?
Politics is its own craft, and you have to learn your craft like any other career. And I needed to learn my craft also. And I've always said that if I'm any good, I won't need to tell you, my work will speak for me. And so I've just slowly and methodically let my work speak for me until it reached that point where senior people were able to say, Shane, we'd like to lift you, we'd like to bring you closer to our decision-making.
This has been a great chat, and I worry now that you're going to be forced by this question to play politics. But how is Judith Collins the right person to lead National out of such a catastrophic defeat?
First of all, she has the uncontested support of caucus.
For the time being, right?
For today and right now, we have said, Judith, you are our leader. Take us through to 2023. And that's the mission I've got in front of me, to be the engine behind her, to help us and to get the best of all of caucus to be successful.
Is she the right person? 25%?
Yes, she is the right person. Our caucus have all put their hand up and said, Judith, lead us to success in 2023. Be our Prime Minister in 2023.
And so what do you have to do differently? And I know you've got the review, but I sense, Dr. Shane Reti, you already have a sense of what you have to do differently. What is it?
Look, I do, and you're quite right. I can't preempt that, because I'll feed that into the process. The process is really important, very important. And so I'll feed my input, we'll all feed our input into that process, and we'll get conclusions from that.
Because people, and we had Matt King on yesterday, and it was a different interview because Matt King had lost his job and it was his last day. He hadn't just become deputy leader. But people keep saying the Prime Minister had the stage and she used it really well. And that's why Labor were re-elected. But I think that's not a good argument for the Nats to run in terms of your rigorous self-assessment. Mm. ACT went from one seat to 10 seats. They didn't have any stage at all. So what did they do that you didn't do? How were they better able to connect with right-wing voters?
Look, I think there's several parts to that, and that's why I expressed it as the external factors, which is what you're talking about here, coronavirus, if we want to be absolutely clear, and the internal factors, and it was a combination of all of them, and which weighting we give to each is a different question. But what I do know is here's the cards we've got. This is the hand we've been dealt. This is the hand we need to do a brilliant job with. That's what I know today.
Dr. Shane Reti, congratulations on the job, and we look forward to talking to you lots over the next 3 years. Thank you for your time this morning.
Namahiki akwe.